Calcium channel blockers, or CCBs for short, are grouped into two main types, dihydropyridines and non-dihydropyridines. Dihydropyridines act predominantly on blood vessels to promote vasodilation. They don't have much direct effect on cardiac function. Examples of dihydropyridines include amlodipine, nicardipine, and nifedipine. An easy way to remember is that these medications end with the suffix "-dipin". The non-dihydropyridine CCBs have a greater effect on the heart muscle cells, decreasing heart rate and contractility. But they are less effective in promoting vasodilation. Examples of non-dihydropyridines include diltiazem and verapamil. In this video, we are going to focus on the dihydropyridines, calcium channel blockers. Dihydropyridine CCBs act mainly on the smooth muscles of the blood vessels. As the name suggests, the CCBs bind to and block voltage-gated L-type calcium channels found on the smooth muscle cells. These channels are responsible for regulating the entry of extracellular calcium, an essential element involved in vascular smooth muscle contraction. Usually, L-type calcium channels open in response to an electrical signal or action potential. This allows calcium ions to flow into the cell from the extracellular space. The rise in intracellular free calcium promotes the release of intracellular calcium ions stored in the sarcoplasmic reticulum. The free calcium binds to a special calcium-binding protein called calmodulin. Calcium-calmodulin complex activates an enzyme called myosin light chain kinase. In the presence of ATP, myosin light chain kinase phosphorylates myosin light chains, or MLC, found on the myosin heads. MLC phosphorylation leads to crossbridge formation between the myosin heads and the actin filaments, and hence, smooth muscle contraction. Vascular muscle contraction causes constriction of blood vessels. By blocking calcium channels, dihydropyridines are able to relax vascular smooth muscle, leading to a sustained vasodilation or widening of blood vessels. This group of drugs are used for a variety of conditions related to increased constriction of blood vessels. They are one of the first-line treatments for hypertension. By definition, blood pressure is the force that blood exerts on the walls of blood vessels. It is basically what keeps blood flowing and perfusing tissues to deliver oxygen and nutrients. Hypertension happens when this pressure is higher than it should be. Dihydropyridines CCBs promotes vasodilation. This in turn reduces vascular resistance and increases blood flow within the vessels, resulting in the reduction of blood pressure. This group of drugs is also used in treating angina pectoris, a pain caused by decreased blood flow to the heart muscle. This is due to the narrowing of the coronary arteries, the blood vessels that supply blood to the heart. In these cases, dihydropyridine dilates coronary arteries and improves blood flow to the heart muscle. In addition, dihydropyridines can treat Raynaud's phenomenon, a condition caused by narrowed blood vessels in the extremities, leading to reduced blood flow. This condition commonly affects the fingers and toes and causes them to feel cold, numb, and even painful. Dihydropyridines work by widening blood vessels, thereby enhancing blood flow to the affected areas. Lastly, dihydropyridines are used to prevent cerebral vasospasms after a subarachnoid hemorrhage. Cerebral vasospasm is estimated to occur in up to 70% of all subarachnoid hemorrhage patients. It is a major cause of morbidity and mortality. Dihydropyridine, specifically nimodipine, helps improve cerebral blood flow to avoid ischemic neurologic deficit and any further complications of subarachnoid hemorrhage. Although generally well tolerated, the dihydropyridines are associated with some side effects. This group of drug, especially the short-acting ones, can cause reflex tachycardia, a rather uncomfortable sensation of the heart pounding. Another common side effect is ankle swelling, which results from increased leakage of fluid from blood vessels. Dihydropyridine-mediated vasodilation is also responsible for other side effects such as facial flushing, dizziness, and headaches. Although rare, these drugs can also cause gingival hyperplasia or enlargement of the gums. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.